All right, we're going to go over how to multiply polynomials. This is part one. So the first one we're going to do is multiplying a monomial by a monomial. So a monomial is a single term. Well, this is just a review of how to multiply and use your laws of exponents. So we have 3x squared times negative 5x cubed. I'm going to show the middle step, although you may be able to do this without showing this step of putting the coefficients together, 3 times negative 5 and x squared times x cubed. You might go directly to what's 3 times negative 5? Well, that's negative 15. And x squared times x cubed, since the bases are the same, they're both x's, then you can add the exponents, and 2 plus 3 is 5, so that's x to the fifth. Now, of course, you could write out x times x times x times x times x and count them up, and you should still get x to the fifth. Here's one for you to try. So put the video on pause and try this one. Negative 8 x to the fifth times negative 1/2 x. All right, are you back? Hopefully you've tried this problem. So let's see if we show the steps here. We have negative 8 times negative 1/2. And I've got x to the fifth times x. Now, remember, x is the same as x to the first power. So we have negative 8 times negative 1/2. Negative times a negative is a positive. And 8 times 1/2, you can cancel, or just think of what's 1/2 of 8. And you're going to get 4. That's the coefficient. And now if we add the exponents here, 5 plus 1 is 6. So it's 4x to the 6th. Hopefully you got the same answer. You can also multiply several monomials together at once. As in this example, you did exactly the same way. We can multiply the coefficients of each monomial together. 2 times 5 times negative 3, that'll give me a negative 30. And we have m squared times n to the fourth times m to the first. So if we add all the exponents here, 2 plus 4 plus 1, that'll be m to the 7th. So I did not write out that middle step this time, but hopefully you're able to follow along. All right, try this problem here. Put the video on pause. Try it and then come back. Okay, hopefully you're back. Now, I threw in some decimals here just for some fun. Remember, the coefficients we're going to multiply together. So we're just going to multiply the 0.2 times the other 0.2 times 3, and we have y to the first for this y, times y to the fourth, times y to the 10th. All right, now how do we deal with decimals? We'll ignore them for the moment. Just do 2 times 2 times 3, which is 12. And then you have to move in one place for each decimal here. One for here, one here. So if you go in 2, it's 0.12. or 12 hundredths. And now for the exponent on y, all the same base, so we add the exponents. 1 plus 4 plus 10 is 15. Now, that's how to write it as a decimal. And of course, if you wanted to write that as a fraction, you can change that to 12 1 hundredths, y to the 15th, and reduce it by dividing top and bottom by 4 to get 3 25ths. Y to the 15th. So that also is correct as well. It's also important that you know that there is more than one way to write the correct answer. So these are two ways, and in fact, this 3 25ths y to the 15th, some people think of this as a y to the 15th over 1 and write it as just one single fraction. 3 y to the 15th over 25. So I imagine most people will just leave it as 0.12 y to the 15th, but all of these are correct. Alright, let's go on to multiplying a monomial by a polynomial. So the difference here is we have a monomial, like 2x to the fourth, times a polynomial, that means many terms, 3x squared minus 5x plus 1. All we do is remember to use the distributive property first, and then we do each multiplication of the monomial by a monomial, as in the previous example. So let's do it. We're going to simply distribute this 2x to the fourth to each of the terms, and be very careful with your signs here. So we have 2x to the fourth times 3x squared minus 2x to the fourth times 5x plus 2x to the fourth times 1. Okay, so let's see, this first monomial, we do 2 times 3 is 6, and then what will the exponent be for on x? You're going to add the exponents, 4 plus 2 is 6, so 6x to the 6th. Here we've just got one minus sign, so it's minus. 2 times 5 is 10, and all right, what's the exponent going to be here? Remember, this is an x to the first power, so if I add the exponents, 4 plus 1 is 5, so I have minus 10x to the 5th, plus, and anything times 1 is itself, so I just have 2x to the 4th. And that's all there is to it. So instead of just having one monomial to multiply by a monomial, you might have a few. So you do the distributive property first. All right, here are two for you to try. So put the video on pause and try these. Okay, are you back? All right, so we're going to distribute the 3x on this first one to both the terms inside the parentheses. So we have 3x times 5x. Now, notice I sometimes just put a little dot between it. Sometimes I use parentheses. That's because it doesn't matter. I want you to realize that you can show multiplication more than one way. So we have 3x times 5x minus 3x times 8. All right, so what's this? 3x times 5x. 3 times 5 is 15, and x times x is x squared. Minus 3x times 8. All I have to do is 3 times 8. So I have minus 24x, and that's our answer. 15x squared minus 24x. All right, let's do the next one. But be careful with our negative signs here. We have negative 7m squared times 2m minus negative 7m squared times 3. Now, you might have noticed that you're going to have a negative times a negative and just written a plus sign here, or you could have thought of this minus 3 as plus a negative 3, and so you may have written this step slightly differently than I've written it. But when all is said and done, we have negative 7 times 2, negative 14m cubed, because remember, when you add the exponents, it's not just m squared. You have to multiply m squared times that other m, so there would be three factors of m cubed. And let's see what's going on here. Well, I have two minus signs in a row, minus a negative. That's going to be a plus. So I go ahead and do my 7 times 3. It's 21, and m squared. So your middle step may have looked slightly different than mine, but hopefully you got a plus sign at the end. Be careful that you distribute the minus sign throughout the parentheses. Okay, here's another one for you to try. So put the video on pause and try it. Okay, hopefully you're back now. So we're distributing a negative x through to each term inside the parentheses here. So I'm going to have a negative x times the 5x squared plus a negative x times the 8xy minus a negative x times x squared y. So what do we have here? This minus in front of the x, what does that really stand for? It really stands for a negative 1. So if you want, you could think of that as a coefficient of negative 1. So if negative 1 times 5 is negative 5, and what's x times x squared? Also remember that has an exponent of 1, and adding the exponents, we've got negative 5x cubed. Here we have one minus sign, so instead of writing plus and negative, I'm going to write a minus. We only have one coefficient, so it's 8. X times x is x squared, and then y. Notice I can't add the exponent on the y. You can only do the ones that have the same base. And the last term, minus a negative, that'll be a plus. And I've got the base of x twice, so if I add the exponents, 1 plus 2, that'll give me an x cubed, and then again, just a y. And that's our answer. You ready for part 2?